last year.
Oh, yeah, that's right. How are you?
I made a film, about you.
You know what? I think I did get it. Yeah, I did. Yeah. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you. Yeah. Jane and beautiful art. You're always a part of this other day. This time it looks much bigger.
Yeah.
I don't think you see. business owners, small business owners and governments, sometimes municipalities come to us and we ask us to design something that attracts people's attention, benefits their business, or relays information. We then crunch all that information in our brain, and we design something on a computer and then come out here and build it with our own two hands. So a lot of that is like stuff that lights up, like neon. A lot of stuff is LED lighting right now. And then some of it is foam, so carved on that 4x8 CNC machine, welded primarily out of aluminum here. Sometimes there's a thin sheet metal, aluminum composite material, fiberboard, various things like that. So all comes from in on flat sheets, or is a piece of plastic or metal, and we turn it into a sign. We kind of punch above our weight at this shop in terms of what we go out and install and things like that. A lot of people just order stuff from China, comes in, goes on the truck, goes on the building, but we try to make everything that we can right here in Trenton, New Jersey at this sign shop. And George has been doing this, I won't say how long, a couple years?
A couple years. You've heard of dinosaurs. I'm a sinosaur.
Yeah, I used to be up on that corner there.
So you didn't have a dog?
I had dogs. I had dogs here. But yeah, they
torches are.
Yeah, sure.
Yeah. No pressure.
Yeah. We're restoring a sign here. This used to be an old exposed neon sign. And, so we're remaking all the glass for it.
Oh. So you bend the glass and everything? You form it?
Yeah, well, the first thing we do is make a pattern. Yeah. So we know what we're doing. We just don't bend it up. We need to this is for the word wine underneath. If you look in the light, you see.
Yeah.
It's
yeah.
Wine. But the pattern's made backwards. Because the glass comes in 4-foot sticks. It comes in different flavors, like colors. You cut the glass to like the length of you want to. I've been doing that for a while. Yeah, so you got the pattern made and. It's just kind of like what you see. Each bend is made one at a time. So put the glass on the pattern and make a mark. Where I want to make the bend. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to bend this angle right here. So I got a mark on there.
Whoa, that is some fire.
Can you wear a
The worst thing you learn
is wear a tie.
Just feeling like it's starting to move a little.
Well, I can see it. You can see it. See, it's getting soft.
Okay.
Here, then I ready to bend. You do a cup of air so it doesn't collapse. And I put it on the pattern and you don't have much time where it cools quick, like I can't move it now. Well, a little bit. So I make the bend, take the marker and go on to the next bend. So this, that's a letter L.
You guys have AC in here for the summer?
No AC, but it's funny. It's actually not that bad. Because when it's real hot, as soon as you step away from the fire, it's like...
cool off.
Yeah.
It's all relative.
Yeah, so there's part of a letter A. Yeah, the first thing you learn is where it's hot at.
Right, no, don't. That was amazing. Thank you so much.
You learn not to touch it where it's hot at. It's like, wow, you're right there. You know, within a quarter of an inch. If you don't know, you'll feel it.
So, what is this?
Yeah, okay, so after the sign's bent up, suppose this one's finished.
Yeah.
An electrode gets welded onto the end.
Okay.
This gets welded on. There's one welded on each end, and there's a giant vacuum pump underneath there. The tube's heated up to like purify the tube, all that wonderful stuff that we breathe. It heats it up, and then it's evacuated out. And once it's cooled off, it's backfilled with either neon gas or argon gas.
Okay, and you get the colors through different...
You get the colors from the combination of two things. The color gas, the neon burns red in a clear tube, and argon burns blue.
Wow.
That and there's a fluorescent powder on the inside of the tube. So this is a clear tube, but there's a powder on the inside. You can see it's... And there's they're fluorescent powders, and fluorescent powders give off light when you put ultraviolet light on them. And so if you put argon and mercury, give off ultraviolet light, and it excites the tube, so you'll get the colors depending on what kind of phosphor is on the inside. Most of the phosphors look white, but that doesn't mean the tube lights up white. Like a green tube is a white phosphor, but it lights up green.
How long have you been doing this?
30 years.
Yeah, I can tell.
So you don't even feel the power anymore now, right?
No, I still burn myself every now and then, because there's not that big of a demand for neon anymore.
Yeah.
I mean, there is, just like on a project like this, like a restoration or something like that, but... traditionally, 90% of neon, you didn't see it. It was behind a piece of plastic. It was just like in a channel letter in a strip mall that had a piece of plastic over it. You didn't know it was neon. That's all been replaced with LEDs, light emitting diodes. So there's not much. But yeah, no, I still burn myself because I don't do it every day. It's like... it's like playing a musical instrument or something. You need to practice it all the time. Otherwise, so every time if I don't do this for a month or a couple of weeks or something, like the first couple of times I'm in there, yeah, I burn myself. Every bend doesn't come out perfect. It's something I either didn't heat it up enough, or you heated it up too much, or you got distracted, or a million different things could go wrong. The glass is hot. Oh, which way am I bending it? Do I bend it this way? Do I bend it that way? I get back into it after I've done it for a few times. It sort of comes back to you that, because when I'm standing in the fire, I've got a mark on here, but I still have to like glance back at the pattern, when it's ready to bend, which way am I going? A million things go wrong with that. I go to bend it and whoops, there was something in my way or something.
Yeah. Oh, wow. We appreciate you taking the time for us.
Yeah, that's terrific. Good for you. That's great.
Later.
All right, everybody's parked. We'll go in. Start the tour.
Where are we?
We're going in this door.
Who are you?
Rain.
What are you doing?
I make sculptures. And that's about it. And I sleep late and I stay up late.
Yeah! Right on. All right, follow Rain.
A man of few words.
I'll slide in.
I guess you guys can all mingle and I'll just start talking. This is a chaotic pendulum. The maquette for the chaotic pendulum, that's at Franklin Institute that I made. Painting by Diane Knight of my wife. This is a Jeff Cotton mobile. The Olympic High Flyer, which was at the Atlanta Olympics. Sculpture by Don Bonham. Sculptures by Wendy Gordon up there. The George Siegel, which I used to work for George off and on, along with Kate and Harry. And one day we were cleaning up and Rena Siegel gave me a couple of sculptures for my... we're not supposed to know that.
Well, I know, I came at a cost.
Right time, right place.
And that's an Otten Wright sculpture. Don Bonham. Yeah. Yeah, by a German artist, Christian Fiedelhuber. That whale is a maquette I made for a whale that I never got the commission for. And then a couple of flyer sculptures up there. The various paintings. The lithograph is by Keith Hendry on the wall here. Another George Siegel sculpture. Kaleidoscope poster, I guess we'll call it. For my sculpture I did at Port Everglades, Florida, for an administration building. Raphael Paterini, Lipo Grant. These are Peter Ambush. It was the TV Guide illustrator for Star Ledger. And various artists, that's Loris, the bunny. And the rest, flea market signs. And this is one of the Lori's relatives, a great grandmother. And then I've set up, like in the back here, I've set up my sculpture garden. It was connected to a sunflower. The dragonfly is over there, right here, and that was also part of the trio. The sunflower is in storage just because it's so big. It's like 8 foot in diameter. It doesn't fit. Then the solar, come on, Mr. Solar Sculpture. I promise I'll put a cover on you as soon as. There's a bust I made when I was at the affiliate myself. And I think Bright Bing Bong added the compliment to it, and I liked it so much.
Green also roadied for AC/DC and can back a truck like no one can. Man, I've seen him back
like
a fucking
cannon,
like...
So, War spelt backwards, raw, on YouTube. And that's how I met. And then I just got into the solar when I was teaching at College of New Jersey, because I was using the engineering lab a lot, and they were building like solar powered cars, solar powered boats, and so I was just like, hey, why don't I build a solar powered sculpture? But the concept is good, but it really didn't take off like I'm hoping. But I just recently, like, there was a NJ environmental call. So I'm going to repurpose the sunflower, and I learned how to render with AI a little bit, which is nice. So I could render the concept close enough, and I sent it in with my application. And my idea is like this 8-foot ring of solar panels, and then I'll either put the dragonfly in the middle hanging or the butterfly in the middle hanging. And that could be my environmental statement. Hopefully they like it.
Yeah.
And I said Artworks could be one of my partners, the nonprofit partner, or anybody that would take it.
I'm sure they'll take it.
And on the first tour, we had a raccoon up in this tree. And it was looking down, so it's on Facebook, on my Facebook page. Keely got a picture of it. There's a squirrel up there?
Directly there.
Oh, no way.
Oh, yeah.
I heard somebody
squirrel. I wonder what it's doing. I think we must have scared it out of the... I wonder what it's doing. Because they're supposed to... I have a hard trap, and I send him to Duck Island now. To the trailhead, you know, the bike trail.
Yeah. I'll watch out for them.
Yeah, it's a real problem, actually. Like,
yeah,
they're overrun, and I guess, like in the city, it's just there isn't the habitat. So.
We have some really nice frames, and you can build your bike.
Sweet.
The second floor is way fuller than here. Even if you think there's a lot of bikes there, second floor is way more.
Oh my.
And when is the South Jersey ride?
I mean, we need to talk to Wales about that.
Thank you.
Giants rave and soar up the new frontiers. Sung in sagas of a fate, determined shield and spears.